And we're here again with Phelan Brook, who is with BMW. BMW, and he's going to talk about now their full hybrid concept vehicle, the X6. So, again, Phelan, thank you so much for taking the time. Phelan Dunk. And let's talk about this car. What differentiates the X6 concept hybrid from the car that we previously talked about?
Yeah, this is the second member of our upcoming hybrid fleet. It's the BMW X6 Active Hybrid, being ready for production in 2009. And the difference to a standard BMW X6 is that this is a full hybrid car. So we have a V8 combustion engine around 400 horsepower, combined with two electric motors of around 60 kilowatts. And what we achieve with this is a reduction in fuel consumption of about 20% in the European test cycle. And it will be the first hybrid on the market that offers good fuel economy, not only in downtown traffic, but because of its special transmission, also when you're going country roads and interstates. Okay. You probably know that so far, hybrids that are on the market today, they offer good city fuel consumption, whereas on country roads and interstates, the additional weight of the hybrid technology is rather a disadvantage. And the two-mode transmission within the BMW X6 Active Hybrid overcomes these former disadvantages.
Okay. Now, this is then similar to the technology. This was technology co-developed with GM,
Chrysler, and Mercedes.
And Mercedes, right, and has found its way into their vehicles. What are there any functional differences between this hybrid system, battery and motors and so on, and the systems in those vehicles? Is there anything that has a special BMW characteristic
right
to it?
Yeah, the transmission itself, the two-mode transmission, is the same as it will be used with the other manufacturers, but we had the freedom to adapt it in a way that it feels like a typical BMW. So the response, agility, sportiness will be, of course, different from competition. And whatever we do within BMW with new technology, every BMW has to feel like what you're used to or what you know from BMW. So the BMW Active Hybrid will be the BMW amongst hybrids, meaning the most sporty and dynamic one. Very important for us.
Okay. Now, the battery technology, obviously, in the other car, we were looking at a 800 watt hour battery pack, which is relatively small. This, mm-hmm. I would assume, would have somewhat larger battery pack.
It's a larger battery pack because the car is able to drive electrically without support of the combustion engine. And it is not lithium-ion technology. Is how do you call it?
Nickel metal hydride.
Yeah, because when you are aiming for such high performance as it is needed in a full hybrid vehicle, lithium-ion technology is not yet available for that. Would be a next step, but for the start, it's this technology.
Okay. Now, this car will become available in 2009. And will that be a worldwide release as well?
It's a worldwide release as well. Okay. Left-hand steering. We cannot do everything at the same time, right. So right-hand probably after.
Okay. And again, probably there'll be some announcement in the future with respect to the pricing of the vehicle?
Absolutely. We can expect pricing details somewhere early summer next year.
Okay. And have you driven this, either of these vehicles?
Oh, I certainly did, yeah.
And what are your impressions, personally?
First feeling is it feels like a BMW. That's very important to us. And at the fuel pump, you have that additional experience. Wow, it's 20% less on the bill.
Do you feel that the market in Europe is a better market for this technology than the United States, or the United States do you think would be more acceptable to electric hybrids given the predominance of diesel technology and acceptance of diesel technology there?
Yeah, that's an interesting question, and we think that no matter whether it's the US or Europe, diesel technology also in future volume-wise will be the much, much bigger part of the market than hybrid, because hybrid continues to be a very expensive technology for the customer, no matter whether it's mild hybrid or full hybrid. And it will be interesting to see how it develops in the US. We are just about to introduce diesels to the US with our first two models. We are starting now in December 2008. Okay. And we will see how the market responds. And then we will have the opportunity next spring to do some fine tuning to see how things develop and how diesel compared to hybrid will develop.
Okay, good. Thank you again, vielen Dank.
Thank you for your interest.
Okay. All right, bye-bye.